continuation with the topic Mendel. So based on the observation of Mendel's experiment on garden pea, Mendel drew some important conclusions on garden pea, and they are known as the Mendel's law of inheritance. So before starting with that, we should know some basic terms which are related with the law of inheritance. So I am going to explain one by one.
The term dominant, the characters which are physically noticeable, that are known as the dominant, and the other is the recessive, in which the characters can be hidden or suppressed. And the other term is monohybrid, which differ constantly in one character. And the other term, that is dihybrid, which involves two pairs of contrasting characters such as a height and color of the flower or shape of seeds and their color. The other term is segregate, or means separate. Then independent assortment. It means that the characters, they are not dependent on each other for the distribution of the pair. So these are the basic terms. With the help of the diagram, Mendel studied seven pairs of contrasting features of garden pea. So the character, that is a flower color, the purple, that is a dominant trait, versus the recessive trait, which is white one. So the characters which are dominant are shown with the help of the capital letters, and the recessive trait, they are shown with the help of a small letters. Then there is a seed color. One is the yellow, that is a dominant, and green is the recessive. Seed shape, round, and the other is the wrinkled. Pod color, that is green, which is dominant, and recessive is yellow one. Pod shape, inflated, that is dominant, and constricted, that is recessive trait. Flower position, axillary, which is dominant, and terminal, that is recessive. In plant height, the one that is tall, which is dominant, and the other is dwarf, that is recessive. So these seven pairs are studied by Mendel. Mendel's generalizations of the results of these breeding experiments are summarized under three laws. Number one is the law of dominance. In this, out of a pair of contrasting characters present together, only one is able to express itself while the other remains suppressed. So the one that is able to express, that is a dominant character, and the other that is unexpressed, that is known as the recessive. So recessive character can express only when they consist of both recessive pairs, such as if a purple flower is there which shows a dominant character, and white, that is a recessive trait. So in these both breeds, only the purple flower character will be shown in the flower, because purple is a dominant character. Is law of segregation. It means that two members of pair of factors, they separate during the formation of gametes. They do not blend, means they separate into different gametes. That is why it is known as the law of segregation. Last one is the law of independent assortment. In this, when there are two pairs of contrasting characters, the distribution of the members of one pair into gamete, it is independent of the other pair. It does not depend on the other, and they show their own character. So this is a brief description of Mendel's law of inheritance.